Thank you, Paul. Well, finally tonight, some of the cars of the future were put through their paces in Geelong over the weekend. But none of them had drivers. And as Cameron Best reports, some of them didn't really look like cars at all.
This is Buttercup.
Navigation standard.
It's neither cow nor car, but under the bovine livery is a wealth of technology to get Buttercup moving and accelerate the future of self-driving vehicles.
So we've got a couple of different sensors. We've got the laser that you can see on front under the cow hat. That's for detecting the barrels and fences that we've got out there. We've got two cameras on top that we use to see the lines that we need to stay between. And on the top, there's two GPS receivers, and that's what we use to determine where we are within the course.
While Google has been working on a self-driving car for some time, this competition started last year among universities in a bid to advance autonomy capability in Australia. Throughout the three-day competition, pit crews punched in last-minute instructions on navigating the obstacle course. But after that, it's hands off.
The fact that the robots are fully autonomous, you basically push the go button, watch them go around the course and cross fingers, and it's really quite amazing what they're able to do.
While self-driving cars might be a thing of the future, they may not be as far away as you might think. Look at this. This prototype is both automated and remote controlled. And it goes all right.
But anyone looking for a Christmas present for the person who has everything might have to wait just a little longer.
Well, we've just shown that we've got the capability of avoiding obstacles and staying between lanes, so surely autonomous cars aren't too far from that.
Mm-hmm.
Buttercup will represent Australia in an international robotics challenge in the United States next year. Cameron Best, ABC News, Geelong.
Now, before we go...